कृष्णवर्णं तिशाकृष्णं सांगोपांगास्त्रपार्षदं यज्ञैः संकीर्तनप्रायैर्यजन्तिः सुमेधसः अन्तः कृष्णं बहिर्गौरं दर्शिताङ्गादि वैभवं कलौ संकीर्तनाद्यै स्म कृष्णचैतन्यमाश्रिताः जयतां मथुरा भूमौ श्रीलरूपसनातनौ यौ विलेकयतस्तत्त्वं ज्ञापकौ पुस्तिकामिमां कोऽपि तद्बान्धवो भट्टो दक्षिणद्विजवंशजः विविच्य वेलिकद्ग्रन्थं लिखिताद्वृद्धवैष्णवैः तस्याद्यं ग्रन्थनालेकं क्रान्तव्युत्क्रान्तखण्डितं पर्यालोच्याथ पर्यायं कृत्वा लिखति जीवकः यश्रीकृष्णपादाम्भोज भजनैकाभिलाषवान् तेनैव दृश्यतामेतद् अन्यस्मै शपथोऽर्पितः श्रीमद्भागवतं श्रीमन्मन्त्रदेशिकमीश्वरं श्रीमद्भागवतार्थानां सन्दर्भं कर्तुमाश्रये अथ नत्वा मन्त्रगुरून् गुरून् भागवतार्थदान् श्रीभागवतसन्दर्भं दर्भं वश्मि लेखितुम् यस्य ब्रह्मेति संज्ञां क्वचिदपि निगमे याति चिन्मात्रसत्ता व्यंशो यस्यांशकैर्स्वैर्विभवति वशयन्नेव मायां पुमांश्च एकं यस्यैव रूपं विलसति परमव्योम्नि नारायणाख्यं स श्रीकृष्णो विधत्तां स्वयमिह भगवान् प्रेम तत्पादभाजाम्
TV's off. Okay. Okay. Just one time, can you open? How many students are there? Yeah, how many are there? 14? 17? Achha. 14 students. So take the attendance every day. They are coming now. Hare Krishna. So yesterday we were discussing Pratyaksha versus defect, non-defective Shabda. So that just started, but we have to discuss further. Anyway, somehow there is no power in our place. Online students, you also please note this point. So we don't have any power here. So that's why I'm not able to see the screen. And also my laptop is completely is chargeless. So, is there? Achha. But it's not. No, it's not. Right. Oh, yes. Achha. Okay, anyway, laptop is there, no problem. Even laptop is not there, no problem. But so the okay, and projector is not working, so I cannot project on that screen. So you have to follow that from your laptop. Slow face mein chalenge. Okay. Yes. So yesterday we were discussing about the Pratyaksha Pramana. Like this. Pratyaksha Pramana is Pratyaksha
జ్ఞానం ప్రత్యక్ష జ్ఞానం ఈజ్ ఈజ్ బేసికలీ ఇట్ ఈస్ సిక్స్ టైప్స్ వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ ప్రత్యక్ష జ్ఞానం దట్ మీన్స్ జనరల్ బేసిక్ డెఫినేషన్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద మెకానిజం ఈస్ ఇన్ ద ప్రత్యక్ష జ్ఞానం హౌ ద నాలెడ్జ్ ఈస్ అటైన్డ్ ఇన్ దిస్ త్రూ ద ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రమాణం senses are contacting with the sense object so by this contact so it is like that actually mechanism if you see there is a soul and after that there is mind and after that there is senses there are senses and after that sense objects sense objects so senses are touching or contacting with the sense objects this is the interface and after that these senses are contacting with the mind and mind is contacting with the soul and cognition is happening to whom to soul so this is a mechanism for example if this is a pen then he is coming to know this is pen its object is pen so then this is pen this kind of knowledge is generated in this pratyaksha pramana what is necessary contacting of sense objects with the senses is necessary is important without this cannot happen so now these senses are how many types five anyway mind is there here okay these are the knowledge senses the board is visible to the online students letters are visible or not shall I increase the font yeah five senses are there very good so mind so now so that's why if here we are using the eye to get the knowledge in this process then that knowledge is known as chakshusha pratyaksham chakshusha pratyaksham next if we are using the ear in the senses so ears then that is shrotra pratyaksham like this that means ears are contacting with the sense object that is a sound and then so that information is finally attained to the it is soul yeah now here one point yesterday we were discussing manasa pratyaksham important thing is manasa pratyaksham pratyaksham in the case of manasa pratyaksham pratyaksham how it happens the mechanism is here okay always old students are difficult to handle it is difficult to handle old students so manasa pratyaksham that means knowledge attained by the mind that means here mind is a sense in the whole process anyway mind is involved but here in the manasa pratyaksham case so mind itself is a sense mind itself is a sense and what is the object of this mind what is the sense object that we have to also understand so that object is desire is ichha sukha dukkha dvesha and all these are they different like the sukha means So happy, pleasure, happiness, dukkha, sorrow, desires, sorrow, and so all these are the objects for the mind. So that means mind is touching with this object, is gone. That means there is sansarga. Then so we are getting the, that means knowledge about that object. Okay, so this is known as manasa pratyaksham. This is the, yesterday I said one point. If someone is, that Nama Sankirtan Prabhu was asking at the end of the class, after the class in the doubt session. So he was asking, so what is manasa pratyaksham and what is the difference between manasa pratyaksham and the anumana? So he was, that is a question. So there, so I said that, so you are from Russia, so you are seeing this someplace in the Russia, and after that, so you are remembering that, but that is not manasa pratyaksham. Okay, that has to be corrected. So if you, that is not manas pratyaksham, that means you are remembering something which already you experienced. So that is not manas pratyaksham. That is only what? That is only smriti, remembrance. So what happens generally, if you experience any object, if you experience any, like pen, so or otherwise anything, gulab jamun or anything, object is there. So then what will happen? So that through senses, so the impression is, that means when you experience any sense object, so that is that experience is coming to whom? Finally, soul only. So but related to that experience, there is a samskara is formed. Initially, what is formed? Samskara. From that samskara, so smriti will be formed. Smriti will be formed. So like this, so now when you are trying to remember, you are recollecting from that smriti, you are recollecting that smriti. So that is not, so actually manasa pratyaksham, that is a different phenomenon actually. Okay, manasa pratyaksham means mind is just these are the objects for the mind. So it is contacting with these objects. So in the Tarka Sangraha, it is given. What are the different gunas which are experienced? Like you see, like now you have five working senses, five knowledge senses. Those are the eyes, ear, nose, skin, tongue. Eyes are grasping what quality? Form, rupa. Tongue, taste, rasa. Skin, touch, sparsha. Nose, gandha, smell. Ears, shabda, sound. These are the objects for the senses. Sense objects, these are the. Of course, there will be different padartha. Maybe the pen, maybe the mobile. All these are all having the form. Ultimately, what we are grasping, this is maybe object. This object is shelter for the some form, the form. And that form is received by the eyes. Basically, every object is having the so forms, and those forms only absorbed by the eyes. That means the color form means what you can take. That can be the color, that can be the shape. So now for the mind, then what is the object? That is Icha, Sukha, Dukkha, Dvesha, so and so. There are the 24. Like this, gunas are there. 24 gunas are there. In that, mind is grasping these. Yes, exactly. I got that. Okay. Rupa rasa gandha sparsha sankhya parimana pratattva sanyoga vibhaga paratva paratva gurutva dravatva sneha shabda buddhi sukha dukkha ichha dvesha prayatna dharma dharma samskaraha. Okay. So in this sukha dukkha ichha dvesha, these are the qualities. And like the eyes are grasping the form. So here, few examples I am giving for the mind. So what are the objects? Ichcha means desire. Sukha, pleasure. Dukkha, pain. And dvesha. So that is envy. Like this. Okay. So that is a manas pratyaksham. So knowing about this desire, pleasure, pain, envy, all these. That is a manas pratyaksham. Clear? Manas pratyaksham? At least some extent. Yes? It's not clear. No, mind is directly is perceiving this. Mind is perceiving these qualities. Dream. The objects you are seeing in the the objects in the dream, you are asking. Yeah, we can say. And also I will check, but so we can say. Yeah. So we can say. So even the objects which are in the dream, so those are also so seen through the mind only. Not these knowledge senses are not involved in that. Because so there is a disconnection between the user and mind at the time of dream stage. So dream stage, we are not using external senses. We are seeing, you know, at that time also. Okay. Next. In the case of yogis, just I want to mention a few points related to the this topic. So yogis, when they see like the Vyasadeva, just now we are getting in the fourth chapter. You know, you are all going to read in the fourth chapter what is said. It is said that, no, in the fourth chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam. So he is, Sakadachit Sarasvatya Upasprushya Jalam Suchihi Vyukta Desha Asinaha Udite Ravimandale Paravaragnaha Sarishihi Kalen Avyaktaram Sam Yugadharma Vetikaram Praptam Bhuvi Yuge Yuge. So Vyasadeva is seeing the future of the, that means our this yuga. So in the future, what is going to happen? Yuga dharma vyatikaram. That means there will be a so great fall of the so yuga dharma. In the coming days of the Kali Yuga, the people will be very much unstable actually, and they don't follow the dharma. So that's why seeing this, and he is dividing the all the Vedas, and also he is giving the Puranas, this thing. So division he did. That's why he is known as Vyasadeva. So here he is seeing the future. What is it is meaning? Here also is a seeing is happening. So future, that means future, what he is seeing? He is seeing the falling of Dharma he is seeing. So how he is seeing? So what is that kind of pratyaksha? One may get that. Huh? What? You want to give answer? What is that means out of these six, what is the, what kind of pratyaksha it is? You want to say?
It is not pratyaksha, it is shabda praman, because he knows the shastra, he's speaking from that.
So but he is seeing not only just a shastra actually, he is seeing actually. He is seeing is different. Seeing word is used in the
direct perception only. So Shastra is hearing actually, that hearing and after that. So that is the Shabda Pramana is different actually from the direct perception actually. So Trikala Darsi means what? What is happening there inside? What is the mechanism inside? So we have to understand, because but the sense objects are not there. Because in the future, what is happening, he is seeing. So the to get the direct perception, there is a need of the contact of the objects with the senses. That is necessary for the pratyaksha. That is a basic rule or not? That is a basic rule. But that is the but object itself is not there. So then how? So this is also we accept as, that means nyayikas. According to the philosophy of Nyaya school, I am saying. So they accept this as. So this also is a pratyaksham, but in the case of yogis, so even the sense objects are not there. So they accept that as pratyaksha only. So the Vaidusha or not Vaidusha, that is another factor. If that yogi is perfected, then he is Vaidusha. Otherwise, he's not Vaidusha. But he is seeing the future objects. So yogis, so that is also known as so pratyaksham, but there that rule is also defined there in the Nyaya book, you can see. So without the sense objects, they see the future. This is also pratyaksha only. So this is there, and one more thing is, this is seeing future is one more thing, that is the material objects only, material conditions. And one more thing is seeing the, that means when once, that means jivatma get, that means purifying his heart, that means bhakti yoga na manasi samyak pranahite male apashyat purusham purnam. So apashyat is said, that means Vasudev, one more time he is seeing the, he went to the samadhi, that means in his pure heart, that means pranahite male. So in his pure heart he saw Krishna and also Maya. So then what is this, is what? So what about this apashyat? That means apashyat means he saw these objects, Krishna and also Maya. So that Maya is controlling the jivatma, in that way he saw. So these objects he saw. So what is this pratyaksha? There they definitely, these material senses are not at all is involved in that. So then he is seeing in the heart actually. So this, so how he is seeing this? So what is this mechanism of this seeing? What is the mechanism actually? That means this soul is there. Then after that, heart means his purified heart is there. Then how these objects are perceived? Perceived, that means how these objects are perceived. So, but I have no much clear idea on this. But Prabhupada was saying in the many places, so these jivatmas, that means by doing the devotional service, our senses are perfected, pure. That means those will be transcendental. That means those will be spiritualized. The senses are will be spiritualized. So I am speculating this. I don't have complete understanding on this, but I am speculating. Maybe jivatma is getting this some spiritual body actually. So that is spiritual vision. That means spiritual eyes. Prabhupada says spiritual eyes. He is getting the spiritual eyes. So that means, that spiritual body, through that spiritual body, so that spiritual senses he is getting jivatma. So jivatma is getting the spiritual senses, and by that he is able to see the Lord in the heart. So So that means here also senses are there, spiritual senses. Anyway, heart is completely spiritualized. That is, a spiritual heart is there, and jivatma is contacting that object. Like you see, when you offer the prasadam, so prasadam is what? Is anyway, is, before offering that, it is a, just it is material. It's made up of the five elements, earth, fire, water, and so on. So, and but when you offer with the devotion, then it is what? It is spiritualized. What is the meaning of spiritualized? That means, so what is happening in that completely? That means it is, that means the
Lord's devotional shakti, the bhakti shakti is induced in that actually, is charged in that actually. Yeah, is charged. Similarly, so otherwise, what is our philosophy? Any object, if you use in the service of the Krishna, so then that is spiritualized. Like Prabhupada is also giving the example that if you keep an iron rod in the fire, so then after that, this iron rod is also becoming the fire. So similarly, when you engage this body, hands, legs, and ears, everything in the service of the Lord, those will be spiritualized. Those will be spiritualized. That means you will be having the, so that spiritual vision. So that spiritual eyes are given to the Jivatma. So through that, he is seeing in the pure heart, the Lord. So like this. But we need to, this kind of actually axioms, you know, these are all we say axioms. That means the fundamentals that has to be properly taken out from our previous acharya's books, and systematically we should present this. So that means this kind of pratyaksham, how many types of pratyaksham we are accepting. So that means pratyaksham in the baddha jiva case. So that is happening due to these gross senses. But in the case of the devotion, that means when we are becoming perfect, so at that time, that means we are also seeing the Krishna directly. So there we are seeing with the eyes of the spirituality. So then what is that pratyaksham? So that pratyaksham is also happening with that spiritual senses. So that foundational points has to be compiled very systematically. That is, every sampradaya they do like that. Maybe it is there in another books, I don't know. But so that should be that kind of work is necessary actually, so that we will not be having any confusions. So in the spirituality, this is happening. This is yes.
There is one sloka in Bhagavad Gita, yeah, which is referring the yogis who see the experience the happiness through intelligence. Sukham atyantikam yattat buddhi grahayam atindriyam veti yatrana chevayam sthitas chalati tatvata. So sukham, atyantikam, and buddhi, grahayam, and atindriyam. Again, beyond senses, but realized by intelligence, buddhi, and that is sukha. So I think this is something between two, maybe transcendental senses and this material, maybe in between somewhere.
Yeah. So actually, anyway, so this is, we are studying this sandarbha, we are studying so that we can go further and further deep and try to learn. So it's not that I know everything. So I am also learning from all of you. So this much understanding I have till now. So let's see further. So if we get, so that means Vyasadeva is seeing future, that is different. Seeing future means there Krishna is, that future is not there in his heart. That means he is seeing future, that objects still are not there. So that is one seeing, and he is seeing the samadhi Krishna. Their object is there. That is Krishna himself is the object. So that seeing is different. So like this, there are the various types of the, that means pratyakshams are the possible. Okay, come to this. Then after that, yes. Pratyaksham, yeah. So, what is that? So come again. What she is asking? Pratyakshavagamyam dharmam. So, sukham kartum avyayam. Yeah. Devotion is what? Pratyakshavagamyam. That means it is directly experienced actually. This bhakti jnanam is directly experienced, directly, pratyakshavagamyam. And it is directly, and susukham, and also it is so blissful. And kartum avyayam, it is not decaying at any time. So this is also, yeah, pratyaksha, all the devotional process, so is pratyaksha actually, is pratyaksha. That means we are directly experiencing. It's a direct experience. It's not that the just shabda or the it was just speculation, or that means it's just interpretation. No, Bhakti is what? Is directly experienced, actually. It's direct experience. That's why it is comes under which, out of the pramanas, which kind of gnanam it is? Devotional. So experience is pratyaksha only it is. So that means when you get the perfection, so you are seeing the Lord. So that means how? That is, you are directly seeing Him. In the perfected stage, we see the Lord directly. Now what? We are hearing about Him from the Shastra. So now we are not directly seeing Him. But when we become perfect, then we directly see Him. So just we are hearing about Him. We are hearing about the Krishna. So, but when we become perfect, then we can directly see. So, even in the case of, yeah. Anyway, okay. So, give one chance. What he's asking? Quickly.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu.
Very quickly, Prabhu, I wanted to understand that when you are saying mind has objects like desires, pleasure, pain, and envy.
Yes.
So desire, I can understand, like, because mind, I see mind just as a thoughts. So nature of thoughts is nothing but mind. But when you say mind, do you mean more than just mind? Is it like something...
Yeah, mind is like a sense, actually. It is like a sense. It's not just a storehouse of the thoughts, but it is, that is one feature of the mind, actually. It is, now we are taking here mind as a sense. Sense means what? Which grasps the quality from that object. That is known as sense, actually. So in that way, we are using the here mind. Mind definitions also are many, actually. It is also, once again, is a big discussion if you open definition of the mind.
Just, Prabhu, I wanted to understand, is when we are saying mind here, does it mean antahkaran, where it includes heart? Because we cannot feel pleasure or sorrow till it reaches its heart, because all the feelings, my understanding is that we only feel through heart.
Yes.
So how to grasp that idea?
Yeah. So what is happening in the antakarna? So here also, once again, if you go to the Advaiti school and if you go to the Nayayikas, so they are also having some differences in this process itself. They're also having some differences. So like Gaudiya process also, we should define actually very thoroughly. That is still is needed. Gaudiya process, that means how this mechanism, that means mind, soul, mind. So next after that, senses and sense objects. And even the mind also, we can see intelligence. And after that, antakarna, chitta, like this. All these words very technically should be defined. So that is... Is there any it is there in any book? Do you have any idea? No, not like that. I am asking what? So the basic definitions of this like this. No, it's not there actually. That is actually So that has to, after reading that means Sarva Samvadini and many other books like Govinda Bhasha, and after that one should reconcile and everything, and so that we should not go, or we should not deviate from the previous acharyas and define for the our sampradaya. That has to be done, actually. Anyway, now he is asking, so the point is, these objects like the Icha, Dvesha, Sukham, so how they are so perceived by the mind. So those generally, in the Antakarna itself, these are the different vrittis. If you go to the Advaiti school, so how they say these things, that means this is a desire. Desire is also so many types. So desire to eat rasgulla, desire to eat so gulab jamun, desire to eat rasmalai. So like this. And desire to see Taj Mahal, desire to see some ponds, desire to see, these are all. So now, so these are all the different feelings or otherwise. So those are perceived by what? By the mind. Those will be perceived by the mind. So if mind is not there, then we cannot perceive these different feelings. Otherwise, we can are the vrittis. Advaitins, they say these are all as vrittis, and we can say these are all the different. Nayakas say these are all the guna, actually gunas. Advaitins, they say these are all vrittis. Here, these people, Nayakas say this as a guna. So these are perceived by the mind. So, but anubhava is happening to him. Anubhava is happening to the soul.
So Prabhu, the distinction which I wanted to make is like desire. How I understand is nothing but a thoughts. Now
the feeling.
We cannot desire anything if we have not experienced it. So thought can only come from our that eternal reservoir of our samskaras. Like samskaras are, if we have experienced anything, then that sits somewhere in our infinite memory as samskara. So thought can come only if you had experience of it in the past. So if thought is coming, but then when this thought is going and turning into a senses of whether pleasure or sorrow and other things. So I'm just trying to distinct where that boundary is between the soul and the mind, which we are seeing on the screen, like how, where that boundary is.
So, yeah, this is actually mind is becoming the tool. So you are asking now another question, actually. Now you are asking what is the distinction, are they the boundary line between the soul and mind? So these things, if you want to know very clearly, so these things are explained in the Sankhya Tattva Kaumudi, actually. If you go to the Sankhya Tattva Kaumudi, then you will understand. So what is the role of intelligence? What is the role of the mind? What is the role of the senses? What is the role of the sense objects? On the top of that, this Purusha is there, Purusha. So like this, there we can discuss. This is one more big process, Prabhu. So how the steps, that means if you are desiring something, what the mechanism is happening, how the mind is involved in that, how the intelligence is involved in that, how the senses are involved in that, how the soul is involved in that. That is once again, there's okay, Prabhu, it's going into different direction that is there. Actually.
Thanks, Prabhu.
Yeah. But the hint is, you can see from the, so Sankhya Tattva Kaumudi, this is there, this is explained. Okay. Huh? Who? Nam Sankirtan, you could take his. That is his question only, actually. Okay. Quickly.
Actually, I think we already discussed what I wanted to ask. Thank you.
What are you saying? Oh, yeah, sir. Okay. Okay, we'll take later. So now come to the, so you I'm just opening the doors where you can do even more research and find the things you can explore. So just I gave the little information, but you, that's your interest, actually, how much deep you want to go. Okay, next, after this discussing the so pratyaksham. That is total how many? The six into two, savikalpa, nirvikalpa. That means everyone is 12, two types. That means 12. So then after that, vaidusha, it is 24 total. 24 types of pratyaksha jnanam is there. So now after that, now we started to actual discussion. We are anyway leaving the vaidusha pratyaksha jnanam, we are leaving out. Because anyway, that is defectless. That is there is nothing is wrong in that knowledge, that prama. So that is left out. Then after that, we are going to the, so avaidusha pratyaksha jnanam. Avaidusha pratyaksha jnanam. So avaidusha pratyaksha jnanam versus ब्रह्मादिरहित शब्द ज्ञान ब्रह्मादिरहित शब्द ज्ञान In the initial stage, whatever is given in your handouts, if you learn that, that much is as expectation from the Tattva Sandarbha. So after learning that, then you can go into the now whatever I said, these the various types of the Manas Pratyaksham and going and finding the mechanisms. And after that, seeing the role of each and every, that means mind role, soul role, those things will be the, that's, that is a not, that is ever interest actually, okay? Now we are seeing the these two. Here, avaidisha pratyaksha jnanam is vyabhichari, first point. In the pratyaksha, what happens? Here, pratyaksha pramanam is there. Pratyaksha pramanam. Pratyaksha pramanam. And prameya is there. Prameya means prameya, object to be, object of the knowledge. Next, prama is there. Prama, pramanam, prameyam. Prama means here what? Pratyaksha jnanam. Pratyaksha jnanam. One example we took. Shaved head. Shaved head created by the Maya Mandakam. Means created by the magician or musician? Magician. Spelling M-A? So magician. So magician created this head. That is a prameya actually. Okay. So now pratyaksha pramanam is the eye contact of the eyes with this object, this shaved head, Maya Mundam. Then after that, what we got? This Somadatta, what he realized, what he got, what kind of knowledge he got, what the pratyaksha jnanam he got? Not thought. It's not thought. It is what he experienced. Thought is different from the experience. What he experienced? Yeah. What kind of knowledge he got? This is Devadatta's head. This is the knowledge. Devadatta's head is the knowledge. Devadatta's head. Here now you take the real head of the Devadatta is there. It's a real head. This is real head of the Devadatta. So this is the prameyam. Actually, this is Devadatta's head. This has to happen only in the case of this. Yes? This has to happen only in this case. Not in this case. Not in this case, but in this case it should happen. That means what? This knowledge has to follow whom? Has to follow Devadatta's head, real head, not the this. So that's why this is, but it is not following Devadatta's head. This knowledge is not following strictly original head, real head. So that's why it is what? It is Vyabhichari. It is Vyabhichari. So that's why here we should write knowledge is not following the its respect. Why it is not following? This knowledge is not following the its prameya. Why? The reason is the instrument, the pramanam is having the problem. Yeah, defect. This is having the problem. This pratyaksha pramanam. Siddhari is sleeping.
So you are all getting tired, huh? Yeah. Your mind is your mind is becoming not following the teacher. It is okay, you can ask what is it.
Yeah. The knowledge which I'm receiving.
Yeah, tell me, what is your question?
What my understanding was, think that this magician's head.
Yeah, magician's head.
That is Prameya.
That is Prameya.
Prameya. And that that magician head is what to say, is distributing that knowledge that this is Devadatta's head to this person, the Somdatta. So this knowledge which is coming out from the magician head,
you are saying this is defective.
Is not following strictly, not following the head of this, should distribute the knowledge that this is the false head. This is not
who should say, who should do this. This pramana should do, na, this pramana has to. Pramana means what? He is the instrument, actually. He should function properly. He should function properly and he should say, oh, this is not real head. This is magician head. Like this, it should produce wrong knowledge, actually. It should produce that this is not real Devadatta's head. So that kind of active, that kind of output, who should give? Pramana. Pratyaksha Pramana should give.
Who is Pramana here?
Here, Pratyaksha Pramana. Eyes.
So
contact of the eyes with this object.
So eyes is pramana, and eyes is not strictly following. Vyabhichara is eye.
This is pramanam, and it is producing the gnana. Prama is produced by whom? By the pramanam. Prama means knowledge, yeah. Right knowledge. Right knowledge is produced by whom? Pramanam. So what is the prameyam? Is this? So now there is no problem in the prameya. Prameya can be anything. It may be the shaved head. It's a imagined head, imaginary head, or it may be the real head. But pramana, what it should do? It should do all the time. So give the right knowledge, actually. This is a imaginary head. This is a shaved head. Sorry, it is a real head. Like this, proper information. So our proper knowledge should be generated by the pramana. But it is not generating proper. It is giving the wrong knowledge. So that's why. So this knowledge is becoming avyabhichari. That means it is not following strictly its own real prameya. It is following even the false prameya also. So this knowledge is following false prameya. Getting, Prabhu?
I am thinking that this prameya is not vyabhichari towards the magician's head.
This prameya, what you are saying?
This prameya, prama, is not avyabhichari for the towards magician's head.
It is avyabhichari, no.
Towards magician's head. Because see, this person, when he's in audience, he's seeing the head, he should think that this is false head, is it not? So that avyabhichari towards that false head.
No, your point is not clear, so actually.
Devadatta is not in the picture here. He's not there. Picture is only that real, that khopri of the magician.
Yeah.
So that this not vyabhichari towards the khopri, that false head, that knowledge. Not Devadatta is not in picture here.
No, Devadatta is not at a role. So here imaginary head of Devadatta is there. Okay. So now pramana, what it should do? Pramana should produce that this is Devadatta's imaginary head. It should produce like that, but it is not producing. It is producing wrong, because what it is saying, it is producing that this is Devadatta's head. It is producing that it is Devadatta's head. Like this, it is producing. Please, so you forget everything just to see, hear whatever I am saying. So what I am saying, first pramana is there. Simple, one point. How vyabhichari I am explaining. So pramana is there. Okay, first, that is, those are the eyes. Okay, take eyes. So now here, so imaginary head. So magician created the imaginary head of the Devadatta. Okay, he created this. Now, So this pratyaksha pramana means eyes contacting this magician, this imaginary head. So then what it should produce immediately? This pramana? Sure. It is? This is Devadatta's. This is Devadatta's imaginary head. Like this, it should be produced or not? Devadatta's imaginary head. But it is not doing like this, this pramana. What it is producing? This is Devadatta's real head. Devadatta's real head. Okay? But this jnanam, this is the knowledge generated by the pramana. It should be following whom? Actually, this prameya, real prameya, that means real head. But it is not, this knowledge is not following this, but it is also following temporary imaginary head also. So that means, because of what? Because of this pramana. Pramana is the cause. This knowledge to become vibhichari, who is the cause? Pramana is the cause. Pramana is, pratyaksha pramana is the cause for this knowledge to become vibhichari towards its prameya. My God, not getting?
By seeing the real head also, it can produce a knowledge, it may be imaginary head also, I think.
That will come. That anyway, vibhichari is, this is accepting, right? Yeah. So that means there is a problem. That means knowledge is vibhichari. Okay. That is another point anyway, that we'll discuss. What? Quickly. 11:30 already, we didn't go.
Just an example.
What do you want to, you want to ask question or you want to comment?
On this question, this explanation, can we just, I was trying to relate this material world and my eye.
Yeah.
When my eye see material world as a separate from Krishna, as real, then my eyes are avyabhachari. But when my eye sees every material world in connection with Krishna, this Krishna's energy, then my eyes are giving a proper knowledge, correct knowledge, and then they are avyabhichari. Can we say?
No, actually avyabhichari, vyabhichari means what? When there is a one, see, there should be two. One is following another strictly. Then there is a vyabhichari or avyabhichari concept will come. So you are saying what? It is a statement. It is not the point of vyabhichari or avyabhichari. What you are saying? So your eyes are seeing so material world as real. So here eyes are not vyabhichari or avyabhichari. The knowledge is produced by that eyes is the vyabhichari. Knowledge produced by that eyes is the vyabhichari. Why you are saying the senses are avyabhichari? Senses should follow whom actually? That means senses should be avyabhichari, means he should see only Krishna. He should see only Krishna and he should not see any other thing. Then how it is possible? Vyavahara, in the vyavahara we see so many things. You want to say senses are the vyabhichari towards Krishna? Means what? Senses all the time they should be seeing only Krishna. So maybe if you say, if you want to bring that point, 1 second. So if someone is seeing everything in connection with the Krishna, so then if he's seeing everywhere, everything is Krishna only, Krishna's energy only Krishna. So yeah, we can say that also. We can say that also. Eyes are vibhichari. So if they are not, because eyes are vibhichari, why, when you can say, that means actual fact is what? Everything is Krishna. Vasudevaha sarvam. So Vasudeva sarvam iti samahatma sudurlabaha. So what is a fact? The fact is everything is Krishna. Everything is Krishna. Okay. So now that means everyone should see only Krishna. That means eyes always should follow Krishna. And for the object, for the eyes, what is object? Krishna is only the object. No other thing is object. So, but now, because of the conditioning state, so someone, that means he is not seeing the Krishna, but he is seeing the, so other than the Krishna. So that means eyes are not strictly following the Krishna. So eyes are following the, so something which is not real. So then that's why eyes are vyabhichari. Yes, we can say that. Okay. Yes or no? Because what is the fact? Fact is everything is Krishna only. His energy is non-different from him. But now because of the some defect in us, because of defect in us, what we are seeing? We are seeing the other than the Krishna. Like here in the case of musicians also, instead of seeing the head of the, that instead of seeing that as it is, that means it is a false head. So the eyes are having a defect too. That's why they are getting they are producing the knowledge that this head is real head. That means their eyes, that means producing the wrong knowledge. So that's why this knowledge is vyabhichari. You can say knowledge also vyabhichari. Yes, you got it? Yeah? Okay, we'll take later. You write the questions and send to me. My God, so much time is going on. If we, then it will take 1 year for the Tattva Sandhana to complete. It will be good actually. We can discuss more so that more realizations and more many things can be shared. Because we have 40 students and 40 members, 40 questions means 1 hour will go off like that. Already gone, 1 hour. Come to our main discussion. So, so like this, pratyaksha jnanam is the vyabhichari towards its prameya because of the defect in the pramana. Yes, the statement you are understanding. Pratyaksha jnanam is vyabhichari. Pratyaksha jnanam is vyabhichari. Vyabhichari towards what? Vyabhichari towards its prameya. Due to defect in pramana. Siddhari Prabhu, clear? Next, second point. After that, we have how many points? 6 points we have. What are those? That means to say Brahmadi Dosha Rahita Sabda as a king, there are the 6 points are there. It is a servant. Based upon 6 points, we are saying Brahmadi Rahita Sabda Jnanam as a king and Avaidish Pratyaksha Jnanam as servant. Next. Nadu Shabda. In the case of the Shabda, Shabda is not Vyabhichari. So that means here Shabda Pramana is there. Shabda Pramanam is there. And here what is the object? What is this? Himalayas and there is snow. There is a snow. And now what is the knowledge here? Knowledge, Sabda Pramana. So Sabda Pramanam is there. And here, knowledge. Knowledge is produced from this Sabda Pramana. What is the knowledge produced? Snow in Himalayas. Snow in Himalayas. This is the knowledge produced. From where? Sabda Pramana. Object is what? Object is, prameya is what? Snow in the Himalayas. Snow in the Himalayas is the object to be known. So, but what is the pramana here? Are we going seeing here? Pratyaksha pramana is this. What is the pramana? Pratyaksha is the pramana here. No, Shabda is the Pramana. So what is that Shabda? Shabda is Pramana means what is that? The sentence, snow in Himalayas. This sentence is Pramana. Try to understand. Shabda Pramana here what? The Shabda, the words. Words are the Pramana. And these words are producing what? Snow in Himalayas. This knowledge is produced. Getting or not? In the Shabda Pramana, what happens? How the Shabda Pramana functions? So first of all, one is hearing the Varanas, letters. That means words. In the words, letters are there and those letters are forming a word. And every word is having the meaning. So for in the Shabda Pramana process, in the Shabda Gnana, Shabda Bodha, how the Shabda Bodha happens? That means verbal cognition. What do you mean by verbal cognition? What is the process in this? Verbal cognition, what happens? What is the mechanism? The mechanism is first, so you will be hearing the words. And after that, next step, what you'll be doing? So recalling the meanings. Meanings of words. Then after that, making connection. Then finally, getting the knowledge. So if you don't know the meaning, can you get any knowledge? Nothing you get. So that's why here what is happening? We are hearing snow in Himalayas. These words are going into us. Then after that, snow, meaning of snow in and also Himalayas. All these meanings we recall. And then finally, we understood that snow in Himalayas. This knowledge we got. So here, this knowledge, this is Shabda Gnanam. This knowledge, snow in Himalayas, this always follows Prameya. Because this is not at all giving any other, it is not defective. It is not giving any other meaning or other knowledge. It is giving all the time, this sentence will give all the time same meaning. This meaning only. Okay? So that's why here, the Natu Shabdaha, that's why it is said. In the Sanskrit you can see, Natu Shabdaha. First time itself, don't go so deeply. Eh? So otherwise you'll be getting so much confusion. Take this much and after that settle it and slowly then put one more step inside and slowly like that. If you go step by step inside, then so first accept these words. Okay, Shabda Pramana this. If you have any doubt, then you go and read the another books actually. There are so many books are available. And see that, understand the, analyze that, and then you get doubt, and then once again dig it like this systematically. Where is that document? Second one is Sapeksham versus Nairapeksham. Sorry. First is this Avaidish Pratyaksham is the Gnanam is the Vyabhichari and Brahmadi Rahita Sabda Gnanam is Avyabhichari. So next point is Yatha Drishtachara Maya Mundena Kena Chit Sati Api Ashradhiyamane Satyam Idam Iti Nabhavanyado.
this is Vyabhichari. Avyabhichari. Second point, Sapeksham. It is Nairapeksham. Okay. That means dependent and it is independent. How? Let us see now. Now, Somadatta went to fields. He went to fields. Okay, Somadatta went to his fields. There he saw head of Devadatta. His head is chopped off and it is lying there. So Devadatta's head. Don't feel it will be difficult to. This is Devadatta's head. And he is thinking, so yesterday he went to the magician's show, na? So there he saw the Devadatta's head. And after seeing the Devadatta's head, so he thought that is real. But everyone said, you fool, it is not real head. That is imaginary. So don't cry. Your friend is alive. Okay. That experience he got. Then after today, he went to field. There he is seeing the head of the Devadatta. That is really, actually, it is real head. So now he is thinking that it is imaginary head. Someone created and he kept this imaginary head. Yes? But he is seeing pratyaksha. He is directly seeing. But what kind of knowledge he is getting? Even after seeing directly that object, the head of the Devadatta, he is getting, this is imaginary head. This is imaginary head of Devadatta. Kya Babu? It is imaginary head of Devadatta. Like this knowledge he got after seeing also. So is it right knowledge? Is this right knowledge? It is not right knowledge. It's wrong. Then from the sky, there is a voice. Hey, Somadatta. That is a real head of your friend. That is Devadatta's head. Then after that, he understood. Oh, it is Devadatta's head. And then he started crying. So means what? Here, Pratyaksha Pramana is dependent on Shabda. Yes? Sapeksham. Getting or not? Nabhavanyadau jananapi ruddopasanam vina na kinchidapi tattvena nirnetum shaknohati iti sarvesham nyayavidham stitihi. Even all the nayayikas also accept in this regard what I wrote in that. All knowers of nyaya firmly believe that it is not possible to determine anything as true without respect for the wisdom of elders. What is the meaning of this sentence? Even the logicians, nayayikas, what is their firm belief? What is their firm belief? They believe that it is not possible to determine anything as truth without respect for the wisdom of elders. That means after hearing from the elders only, they are confirming that knowledge. So that means whatever the perceived knowledge from the directly, so jananapi urdopasanam vina nakinchidapi tatvena nirnayitum shaknoti iti sarvesham eva nyaya vidham stitihi. That means all the nayayikas, they have the belief, firm belief, that anything which is perceived, that means any knowledge is perceived about any object, so that will be concluded after hearing from the experts. Expert means that is hearing from experts means that is what? That is a shabda, which is free from the defects. Brahmadi dosha rahita shabda. Okay. But if you come to the case of the shabda, but it is nirapeksham. That means it is not dependent on anyone. Brahma, that is the Rosha Shabda Gnanam, is not dependent on anyone. What is the example for this? The example is Sabdastu Nairapeksham Yatha Dashamastvam Asi. So there is one small story for this also. So one time, 10 friends, they are going to marriage function. Okay? So his Guruji said, okay, you all go and attend marriage function on behalf of me. All these 10 friends, they are going. So, but before going to that village, there is a river, and they should cross that river. What happened? These 10 students, so they crossed the river. That means they don't have any boat. In the olden days, there was no boat. So such a small village, that is no boats. So they all swimming they did, and after that they came out. That means they reached another side of this river, another bank of that river. Then after that, so they are very intelligent people, and they are counting. Now let us count how many we are. So whether we are correct or wrong, that means someone is missing in the water. So we need to check. So like that, everyone is counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, 9. 9. One is missing. And he is counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Hari, one is missing. And everyone is counting. And so everyone is concluding that one is missing. So, and they started crying. All they sitting and they are crying. So then, so one intelligent person, so like you, one of you, so he is reaching them. And he is seeing, why all these Guruji's 10 students, they are crying. So, and he came to them and he is asking, why you are all crying? So then he said, so one among the 10 students said, so Sisi, we all 10, we started from our Guruji's ashram, but now we are only 9. So then he is asking, so count it. Then he is saying that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 only. Then he is crying. So then that person, the messenger, that's the new person. So he is saying, Dashamaha Tvam Asi. What he is saying? Dashamaha Tvam Asi. That means you are the 10th one. So whenever he heard this word, this sentence, Dashamaha Tvam Asi, after hearing this sabda, immediately he got the knowledge, we are 10. So here what? The sentence Dashamaha Tvam Asi. Dashamas Tvam Asi. Dashamaha Tvam Asi. You are 10th one. You are 10th one. So here, dashamaha tvam. So he said like that. Sayeshaha shabdaha dashamaha aham asmi iti pramayaha tirskarinam moham shravanapada pravesha matra vinirtya ityeveti spashtameva nairipeksham. In this what? Whenever he heard this sentence, that student, whenever he heard dashamaha tvamasi, immediately what kind of he understood? Dashamaha ahamasmi, I am 10th one. So this kind of knowledge is generated immediately. You are the 10th one. The illusion of a person who is rejecting knowledge that I am the 10th one is removed just by hearing you are the 10th one. So initially what? He is having the illusion. What? So what is that kind of illusion? I am not the 10th one. So that kind of, so one is missing. That means I am not 10th one. Is you can say. That means you are the 10th one. So this sentence, you are dashamaha tvamasi, what it did? The illusion of a person who is rejecting the knowledge that I am the 10th one is removed just by hearing you are 10th one. Trying to understand this. There is an illusion. What is that illusion? The illusion of a person, that means, so who is rejecting, that means rejecting, I am 10th one. I am 10th one. So this illusion is rejecting what? I am 10th one. So this illusion is rejecting I am 10th one. So now what happened? Whenever he heard the you are the 10th one, after hearing this sentence, this is a sentence. After hearing this sentence, then what happened? This illusion is removed. That means knowledge is generated. Illusion is removed. Okay, here we are clearly seeing that Shabda is, this sentence is producing the Jnana. That means it is destroying the illusion. What kind of illusion? Rejecting I am 10th one. That illusion is finished. Okay. Questions? We have 3 minutes. Online.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, yes. You were actually just speaking about those five senses and the desires and everything. So what I am trying to understand is that we have subtle senses, we have gross senses, and we have spiritual senses also. So subtle senses actually have to align with the spiritual senses, because the gross senses, they do not cooperate. But if the subtle senses, they align with the spiritual senses, then I think they will be in harmony. Because if these two senses are not in harmony, then we cannot reach the goal that is actually serving the Lord or pleasing the Lord. So please correct me if my understanding is wrong, Prabhuji.
What is this alignment? From where you are getting this word alignment?
Aligning means actually, you know, following the instructions or, you know, obeying to those senses. Because if these senses, they go astray, they do not actually, they reject basically, you know, serving the Lord. So then definitely there will be difficulty for that person to reach the goal of life, actually. So my understanding is that these subtle, until this time, the gross senses are not aligned with the subtle senses. And the subtle senses don't align with the spiritual senses, then reaching the goal of life would be very difficult for a particular person.
Instead of saying alignment, actually here, as we do the bhakti, that means sevan mukhado jihwa, sevan mukhado jihwado. That means when you engage your senses in the devotional service, then these are all spiritualized. What is need of an alignment? It is not alignment. So you can see that even the Prabhupada, many times he uses the word is spiritualized. And also we are giving the example of keeping an iron rod in the fire. So that what it is doing, it's not that there is a one fire of the iron rod and there is a without, and now it is aligned. It is not like that. This itself, this iron rod itself is transformed into the fire actually.
Fire.
So then whenever you engage any energy into the Lord's service, then that is spiritualized actually. So now it is becoming the part of the service. So then that is spiritualized. It's not that we are bringing something differently, because everything is belong to Lord. How can you see that everything is Vasudeva Sarvamiti? So it's not alignment. Everything is Krishna only actually. Everything is Krishna only. But what is the mistake in us? We are losing that vision. That means that connection. Everything is Krishna and Krishna's energy. So I mean, Krishna's and Krishna energy, there is no difference between the Shakti and Shaktiman. So that kind of vision has to be developed. So that means it is already there. And also, so now we have to spiritualize. You have to spiritualize the existing, the material. Even if you use this hand, so this will be spiritualized. That's why we say our gurus, they are all spiritual. So because they fully engaged their body, their mind, their speech, everything is engaged in the service of the Lord fully. So that's why there is no material. That's no material in that body. That we should not consider it as a material actually. It's completely spiritual.
Yeah. Thank you, Prabhuji. Now it's clear, very clear. Prabhuji.
Yeah. Hare Krishna. Huh? Yes, Prabhu. Sachidev Prabhu.
Yeah, Prabhuji, you mentioned just once about intelligence, because intelligence comes between mind and soul.
Yes.
But after that, you didn't say anything. So does all this, what you explained, intelligence has got no part?
It is there. It is actually in this Vedantic language, they don't see the parts. That means mind itself, sometimes you can say. So it is comprised of the intelligence also. So antakarana we say. Roughly sometimes we say antakarana. Antakarana means we are not differentiating mind, intelligence as separate segments. So as a summoned soul, sometimes you will be hearing only the antakarana. Sometimes you will be hearing a chitta. Sometimes you will be hearing.
Okay.
So, yeah.
And where is the location of the mind in our body?
So it is a heart. This is the place.
Yeah, in the core of the heart.
Yeah, it's this. That means which is just, so you have to, this is this much distance you have to measure from your nabi. So there is the heart is there. Here, this is the heart.
No,
this is not heart actually. It's a physical one. That is not heart. So this is the heart, or other way, mind. So in this, so Jivatma is residing.
So Paramatma is residing over there.
Yeah, Jivatma and Paramatma both.
Yeah, and the last question was that, Prabhuji, that you read all these verses, just now Sanskrit verses, but... means that page is there in front of me, what you read, and about that example also you read. But then from where are you, because you read all that, yatha, dasha, dashamastam, ashi, iti, adav, eva. But from where are you getting the English translations?
I gave to you, actually, in the handouts.
The English translations? No, Sanskrit you gave, na, Prabhuji?
In the, Prabhu, I gave the handout English also. In the SS... Anucheda 1.
Okay, Prabhuji. I'll check that. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Thank you for the answers, Prabhuji.
Yes, Prabhu. Hare Krishna. Okay. Mahasev, Prabhu. Okay.
Hare Krishna. Very small thing, may not be that much important, but we discussed about Smriti and Manas Pratyaksha, and then that time dream also came. So dream can also be part of Smriti in Prabhuji. Like,
yes. That I will be clarify, Prabhu. It still that is quite... actually object size, yeah. Na? So it's quite even more thorough research should be done. Okay, thank yes, Prabhu. Others can leave actually. So now you have break. If they want, they
what
can
is leave. The little? If there is some difference, can you little bit explain between Vedantic understanding of Antakaran and our understanding Gaudiya Vaishnava?
Gaudiya Vaishnava actually. So it's like Vedantins. How the Vedantins they explain the Pratyaksha Pramanam is a little bit different. So here, what happens? So Antakarana is there, and this is now this Antakarana is from the eyes. Through the eyes, it is traveling. It is traveling in a channel. That means like the. So if you want to. So, so if anyone wants to leave, they can leave because now it is class is over. It's your choice. And break time is already started. You can take break. And I am explaining just whoever is interested, they can sit. So now this is Antakarana. This is Antakarana. And it is traveling. So and from the channel. So there's a pranalika. We say pranalika. And this is a sense object. Make it as a laddu. You take it as a laddu. Object is laddu. So now this Antakarana is traveling from the eyes to the object. And also it is getting the shape of this object. And then that shape is formed in the Antakarana. This is known as vritti. This is known as vritti. In this way, so this in the process of the Advaitins, this is the mechanism actually. So in this way, so the person who is behind this Antakarana is coming to know about this object by the vritti. So that is their understanding actually. About ours, we have to decide, select some of these. Okay. Hare Krishna. Is Antakarana is comprised of, there's a subtle body, there's a mind, intelligence. You can say mind, intelligence, and everything together is known as Antakarana. Yeah, false ego also. Everything together. It we see in the, so if you want to read this, so Vedanta Paribhasha, it's Advaitin's book, Vedanta Paribhasha, you can see. Jivatma we discuss in Paramatma. Yeah, that is, we don't discuss this. Okay. Thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.